comes to making your own home, selling, buying, and investing goals. And today we're going to discuss what sellers need to disclose to buyers about their home. So whether you've owned your own home for a few years or a few decades, you know its quirks, its best features, and flaws. When you decide to sell your home, you need to be aware that your experience with your home is something you may have to share with your potential buyers. As a seller, you may feel uncomfortable revealing problems in your home that could discourage potential buyers, but it's best to be open about the issues before your home goes under contract. A home inspector is likely to find problems, and the buyers will be less favorably inclined to negotiate with you if they feel that you have withheld information. If a flaw is found after the sale is complete and the buyers have reason to believe you are aware of the problem, you could as well face a lawsuit. The majority of disclosure issues are handled by state regulations, but federal laws apply in one area, and that's lead paint. So if your home was built prior to 1978, it may contain lead paint. Your home must be checked for lead paint and a disclosure form completed unless your home was built after 1978. State regulations vary and often change, so rely on your real estate agent to be up to date on the disclosure requirements for your area. Some states allow sellers to complete a disclosure form listing information about their home or a disclaimer form that says that sellers don't have any information about issues in the property. Things you should disclose to prospective buyers, such as water damage and mold. If you're aware of a leaky basement or a damaged roof or any signs of dampness in your house, you need to let the buyers know about the issue. It's best to provide receipts and insurance claim information so that buyers can see how you address the issues. Hazardous conditions. Some states require sellers to alert buyers to the potential danger of wildfires, earthquakes, and floods in the area. Termite damage. If your home has been previously treated for termite damage, you should disclose this to the buyers. You can also protect yourself by paying for another termite inspection. Repairs and insurance claims. If you know of any repairs you or the previous owners have made, it's best to disclose them to the buyers. Homeowners can request a CLUE report on their home that shows any history of insurance claims for the past 7 years. If you've made any repairs to your property, it's usually best to disclose the information when you list your home for sale, even if local regulations don't require you to do so. If there's an ongoing problem that the buyers will need to handle, it's better for them to hear about it from you so that you can negotiate about what repairs must be made and by whom. If you have a particular concern about your home, you may want to hire a home inspector yourself to get the details before you put your property on the market. Openness about your home's condition is the best way to avoid lawsuits, even if the disclosure is not required by your state. So I hope this information has been useful for you. Please give us a call or send us an email if you have any real estate questions or needs. Also, you're able to get your free instant market valuation on this site by clicking the Home Evaluation tab or click on the Home Search tab to search real-time all properties by all brokerages for the entire Wasatch Front Market.